All right, bubble sort. A very inefficient sorting algorithm, but if you're learning Java, you got to learn how to do it. So I've got my cat. The problem is he just ate, so I can't even trick him with food. All right, so there are a few different ways to do this. I'm just going to show you one that works for me. All right, Lucky, come on, come over here. All right, yeah, good boy, good boy. If I just pet him all the way over here, he won't walk back. That was not true at all. All right, so for my implementation of bubble sort, I'm going to create a pointer. I'm going to call it the right pointer, and I'm going to put it at the end of the array. So if this array is length 7, it's going to go to index 6, 7 minus 1. This pointer will be used in my outer loop, and every time my outer loop completes, I'm going to move this pointer down by 1. Now for my inner loop, I'm going to start at the beginning of the array. So I'll start at index 0. And this inner loop is going to iterate until you reach the index before the right pointer. So I'm not going to go to the right pointer. I'm going to stop right before it. And you'll see why in just a moment. So with my inner loop, I start from index 0 and I just check, is this value greater than the next value? When the value at index, say I, is greater than the value at I plus 1, I'm just going to swap them. So swap places. And then I can move to the next step in my for loop. So now I'm at index 1. Is the value at index 1 greater than the value at index 2? No, it's not. So just move on, next part of the loop. Is 6 greater than 7? Nope. Is 7 greater than 8? No. Is 8 greater than 1? Yes. So swap them. Move to the next part of the loop. Now we ask, is 8 greater than 2? Yes, it is. So swap them, and you can see now why I do not allow I to be equal to the right pointer. Because if I did, then I'd be checking is index 6 greater than index 7, and that's out of bounds, and you'll get an exception. So we have to stop before the right pointer. So I've reached the end of the loop. Every time we complete an iteration of this loop, the highest value will always bubble to the top. So this time the highest value was 8. It bubbled to the very top. The next part of my loop, I goes back to the beginning and the right pointer for the outer loop goes down by 1. So I should expect the next largest value to bubble to the top. I should expect to see, excuse me, Lucky, the 7 end up at the top. So let's see what happens. All right, so we're back at the beginning of the inner loop. Is this value greater than the next value? No, it's not. Continue the loop. Is 5 greater than 6? No. Is 6 greater than 7? No. Is 7 greater than 1? Yes. So swap 7 and 1. Next part of the loop, is 7 greater than 2? Yes, it is. Swap 7 and 2. I should never reach the right pointer. So this is where the inner loop stops. So this inner loop goes back to the beginning and the outer loop decrements by 1. Now back at the beginning, we ask, is the value at index 0 greater than the value at index 1? No, it's not. So let's just move ahead. Is 5 greater than 6? No. Is 6 greater than 1? Yes. So swap them. Is 6 greater than 2? Yes. So swap them. We've reached the end of the loop. The outer loop comes down by 1, and the inner loop goes back to the beginning. Is 0 greater than 5? No. Is 5 greater than 1? Yes. Is 5 greater than 2? Yes. Now at this point, our array is already sorted. So if you wanted to get this to stop early, what you could do is create a Boolean variable, maybe just call it is swapped or swapped. It doesn't matter what you call it. But what you're doing is at the beginning of each loop, you set that value to false. If a swap is made, then your if statement with your swaps should run. So within that if block, you can set swapped to true. And then at the end of your loop, if swapped is true, then you know you should do another iteration. You should continue the outer loop. However, if it turns out that you never made a swap during that particular loop, then your swapped Boolean value will remain false for the entire loop. And if at the end of your loop, if swapped is false, you can just break completely because you know that your array is already sorted because no swaps were made. But if you don't want to do that, then your algorithm would just continue. So inner loop goes back to the beginning and the outer loop decrements by 1. If you had a Boolean value called swapped, it would not change from this point on. So you would see, is 0 greater than 1? No. Is 1 greater than 2? No. Swapped would remain false and your algorithm would just end right here. If you do not create that variable, then your loop will continue. So let's just see what happens. Go back to the beginning, the outer loop decrements by 1. And then we just ask, is 0 greater than 1? No. And we'll set up our outer loop so that the right pointer should be greater than 0, but not equal to. This way, we don't have to do another check over here because this check is pointless. We already checked 0 and 1. So if our outer loop with the right pointer is set to go while the right pointer is greater than 0, then our algorithm would stop right here and we have a sorted array. Right, I'll show it to you one more time, but a little faster. Let me shuffle these. Lucky, you want to help? All right, now while I did mostly shuffle these randomly, I purposely put the largest value at the start of the array. We call this a bubble sort because the largest value is expected to bubble to the top. So if you encounter the largest value, you should end up working with it at every single step of that loop. And you can watch it bubble its way to the top. So let's see what happens. We're going to create our outer loop. The right pointer will be equal to the length of the array minus 1. So right here, that outer loop will go as long as this right pointer is greater than 0, but not equal. Our inner loop, which we'll call I, will start at the value 0 and it will go as long as I is less than the right pointer. Not equal, only less than. So it starts here at 0, and then we ask, is this value at index I greater than the value at index I plus 1, or the next value over? 8 is greater than 0, so swap. Loop continues. 8 is greater than 2. 8 is greater than 6. 8 is greater than 5. 8 is greater than 1. And 8 is greater than 7. I does not become equal to the right pointer. It only stays less than. So back to the beginning, and the outer loop decreases by 1. Is 0 greater than 2? No. Is 2 greater than 6? No. 6 greater than 5? Yes. 6 greater than 1? Yes. 6 greater than 7? No. Back to the beginning, outer loop decreases by 1. Is 0 greater than 2? No. 2 greater than 5? No. Is 5 greater than 1? Yes. Is 5 greater than 6? No. Back to the beginning, outer loop decreases by 1. Is 0 greater than 2? No. Is 2 greater than 1? Yes. Is 2 greater than 5? No. Back to the beginning, decrement by 1. Is 0 greater than 1? No. And is 1 greater than 2? No. No swaps were made, so that Boolean value swapped would remain false. And at the end of our loop, if swapped is false, we should stop. But if you don't create that variable, the algorithm continues. Go back to the beginning, right pointer decrements by 1. Is 0 greater than 1? No. The right pointer should never be 0, so our algorithm finishes and we have a sorted array.